Hi guys, what's up today? I have the desert easy tasks today on the new achievement diaries. So some items you're gonna need are big stack of coins. I like bringing extra coins just in case. So I have 4,900 right here. A pickaxe, any pickaxe works. You're gonna need to mine some clay, which only requires one mining. So any pickaxe works. A bird snare, rope, a weapon to kill some of the creatures in the desert. I just have a whip. A grimy herb of some sort. A knife, an empty waterskin, a shanty pass. An artifact of some sort. I have a golden scarab. You can buy any of the artifacts on the Grand Exchange, I believe, so that's useful. You also need a full set of desert robes. Now, all these, the empty water skins, the knife, the shanty pass, the desert robes, I believe they can be bought from Shanty right here, all for pretty cheap. So his store sells everything pretty cheaply. for pretty cheap. So I recommend having food because you're going to be encountering some high level things. Stamina potions, water skins to survive in the desert, and a pharaoh scepter, which will teleport you to soften him instantly, which is really useful because we need to go down there later. If not, you can just use the magic carpets to get everywhere. So to start off, we can talk to Jar. Just say hello, I have a question, and boom, it starts at the desert. So awesome. So the first one I already have equipped accidentally, but you basically just want to go through and your desert robe one will be finished just like that. Now we want to travel with the rug merchant to Oozer. Don't go to Polynipples, go to Oozer first. So I'll begin recording once I get to Oozer. I'll just fast forward this part since the carpet rides are not that exciting. Also, quick to mention that starting Ichlaritans' little helper is required for this quest, or required for this achievement diary. Alright, and we're going to go ahead and land. Now first off, we're going to run straight north until you hit the water, and then you're just going to follow the coastline up to the mining area where you need to mine some clay. So, waddle that fat ass up there. Look at these goats. These goats have no lives. Like, probably less than 1% of the population of Runescape has seen those goats. Alright, sorry, that was random. Alright, so these first few rocks should all be clay. I think these are all clay, to be honest. Yeah, these should all be clay. So just mine 5 of these. I did not get one on that. You can see in the chat your current progress. So I've mined 2, current stage 2. So 2, 3, 4, 99 mining, here I come. 5, cool, so that's one done. Now you guys wanna run straight back down to where you just were, so I'll begin recording once I get there. So once you've made your way back to close to where the magic carpet is, this time you wanna run west, and you want to keep running west until you see a hunter symbol, because we're gonna have to catch a golden warbler, which is just like a golden bird. So look here, basically if you just run straight west you should see the hunter symbol, and down here will be the golden warblers. Don't get confused, there's also orange salamanders here, but here are the golden warblers. You can see this one's looking so fabulous. So go ahead and place your bird snare and wait for one to get caught, and I'll begin recording once as. Yeah, cool, caught this one. Poor bird, it's a beautiful bird, you know. Look at them feathers, yellow feathers. Very, I'm sure they go up for a lot on the black market, you know. So that completes that one. So from here, you guys are gonna keep running west until you see these two curved bridges. Just bridges, not even curved. Well, they're curved, but all right, come on, Stefan, on topic. Anyways, so keep running west. And you're going to run all the way west to the Calphite Lair. So if you have OS Buddy and you open your map, you're going to see the Calphite Lair is a little exclamation mark. So keep running over there. In this case, we're just going to keep running west. You don't even need to go up to Shantay Pass at the moment, whatever you want to call it. So I'll begin recording once I get there. All right, so we're here. Use your first rope on here and climb down. Now you guys have to make your way through there. Now you need 86 agility to use the shortcut, which is a really useful shortcut. If you don't, you just, was this guy dying? Yes, he is. You have to follow the rest of the path, pretty much. You have to go through the cave like a regular person. So I'll just fast forward this. Okay, so for this next part, we're going to be going into the Calphite Queen Lair, so be careful here, have your prayer on. I really don't remember what to pray, but I'm going to pray range and just see for the best. So before you guys go on, see what I do and hope that I don't die. So use your second rope on the tunnel entrance. And make your way down. And once you're down here, you'll be safe here. Maybe not, I doubt it. I got poisoned, but that's fine. Now we want to go along the edges. Maybe we should pray melee first. And collect the potato cactus. Is that mage? That looks like mage. Okay, so, sketch. Probably doesn't help that I have really shitty armor on. 3, 4, one more, 5. That completes that. Now, we get the hell out of here. And we can just simply teleport. Oh, I don't have any charges left. Awkward. All right, let's see, take the rope back up. Cool. And that completes that. So now if you guys want to bank and get more food and stuff like that, you can head back to the Shanty Pass. I'm going to quickly go to the Shanty Pass. So I recommend using a glory to get there, or just finding a way to get there. You can also just run out and run back if you want. So once you're at the bank, I would recommend go ahead and banking the potato cactus you got, pulling out some more food if you want. Probably won't need it because you won't be in combat for much of the rest of the desert stuff. But so yeah, go ahead and bank all that stuff and we'll get back into it. So let's go ahead and take out another Shanty Pass. And then we're going to go travel with the rug merchant. But this time we're going to travel to Polynipples. So go and travel with Polynipples. And I'm not sure if when you land or when you start, it will. Looks like it's when you land, you're going to finish the task. So I'll begin recording, or I'll fast forward it once I get there. Alright, so once you land, you'll finish the task. Easy stuff. Now, instead of going anywhere else with the carpet, you want to run down south through Polynipples. And this can be done by running south through Polynipples. Yeah, just run south because you want to get to the other side to take the other magic carpet, which you will take end up taking to Narda. So run through Polynipples, ignore everything else but the mouse clicks on your minimap. And you'll see the little arrow there, which indicates the magic carpet's there. And go ahead and travel. And this time we'll go to Narda. So, let's go ahead over to Narda. Alright, so we have made it. And we want to run in there and look for the herb guy, who many people don't use anymore because of grimy herbs now. He's going to be probably pretty lonely. So, Zahur, let's go ahead and see. We need to use some for this grimy herb. Let's use this grimy herb on him. Yes. Alright, and that completes it. So that completes that task. Thank you, man. Much appreciated. Hope you get more attention now. Awesome stuff. So now we're going to go ahead and head over to soften him. Now what you can do is, you can go ahead and travel back to this carpet, the carpet ride, and travel to soften him. I'm just going to use my Pharaoh Scepter, which is going to teleport me right to where I need to go, pretty much. So you're going to, if you travel with the scepter, you're gonna end up in here, and you have to complete a room of pyramid plunder. If not, I'll show you for the people who came from the carpet. Make your way into Sophonum, and once you're in Sophonum, this first pyramid right here, there's like multiple doors to get into. So for the first one, all right, there we go. So he was in the first one. If he wasn't in this first room, you have to go around the pyramid, opening all the like doors until you find the one he's in. Basically, just keep looking for the yellow dot, and we're gonna be up in here with Guardian Mummy. So here's where Thieving's gonna help basically start the mini game with him. And we just have to open the sarcophagus in the first room. So past the spear trap. Sarcophagus is, I failed. I had 70 thieving and I failed in the first room. Classic. All right, open the sarcophagus. That we also got a pottery statuette. God bless. So quick leave the tomb and you're done with that. All right, so for this next part we're gonna have to go talk to Simon Templeton about the artifact we have. Now there's a couple ways to get here. Again, the easiest way is to go ahead and you teleport with your scepter, and and you're going to have these options again. Now, if you use the Jalustrophus teleport, it's going to teleport you right to him. So for those of you who have the scepter, really worth it, then teleport there. If not, he's in between the landslide and the stairs on the agility pyramid. Now, if we go to the minimap, the agility pyramid is right here. So you have to make your way and find him in between the stairs and the landslide. So I'm going to go ahead and teleport with my scepter, and then I'll show you guys how to get there without the scepter. So based on your minimap, you guys remember this this little area right here? Pretty much climb down here to find Simon. Pretty easy. Use the scarab on him. Yes, show me the money. Awesome. And that completes that. So we only have a couple more left. Let's see if we can climb up here. Nice. Alright, so we get up here. Now we have to kill a vulture. So to kill a vulture, we need to go northwest of here. We have some lovely, lovely goats in here. We just have to find the vultures. Those are puppy dogs, aka jackals. So we'll just keep running northwest. And there they are. So kill a vulture. These poor vultures. Desert's a weird place, man. We're gonna punch a vulture to death, because that's a task. Cool, so we killed a vulture. Awesome, so that leaves us with, I believe, one task left, which is cut a desert cactus open to fill a water skin. So let's go ahead and see if we can find a cactus to use. All right, so currently we are at this cactus right here, basically west of this little mining area. So I'm gonna look for a healthy cactus to use my knife on, and I'll show you guys where it is when I get there. And then you guys know where to go. Alright guys, so you remember we were right here earlier, west of the mine. Now we're basically southeast of the mine. We're not here, so it's not that far away. Once you're here, there's going to be some more vultures, and there's going to be a healthy cactus. So just look around, right click on all the cactuses, and when you see Caridian cactus healthy, you just need to click cut. You're going to cut it, slice it up, get some woodcutting XP, and it's going to fill your water skin. So that's it. Congratulations, you completed all the tasks. So simply, let's teleport back to Alcarid. And we're going to run back down and talk to Jar. Alright, so here we are. Let's talk to Jar. And I've completed all the easy tasks. Well done. And we get a Desert Amulet 1. This amulet is a symbol of your exploration. You can now charge a Pharaoh Scepter with 4 charges. Simon Templeton will purchase your artifacts in banknote form, and Desert Goat Horns are dropped as notes. That's pretty beast. Awesome stuff, guys. Where does it teleport to again? I don't know, let's find out. Oh, shit. So, we can't use that yet. Anyways, guys, if this video did help you out, make sure to leave a like. If I did mess up or you have any suggestions, please comment below. Comment if it helped as well. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.